I was born on 1,000 acres of Oklahoma land. Nothing grew on 1,000 acres, for it was gravel and sand. But one day father started digging in a field, hoping to find some soil. He dug and he dug, and what do you think? Oil, oil, oil. The money rolled in and I rolled out with a fortune piled so high. Washington was my destination, and now who am I? I'm the chosen party giver for the White House clientele, and they know that I deliver what it takes to make them gel. And in Washington I'm known by one and all as the hostess with the mostess on the wall. They would go to Elsa Maxwell when they had an axe to grind. They could always grind their axe well at the party she designed. Now the hatchet grinders all prefer to call on the hostess with the mostess on the wall. I've a great big bar and good caviar, yes, the best that can be found, and a large amount in my bank account when election time comes round. If you're feeling presidential, you can make it, yes indeed. There are just 3 things essential, let me tell you. All you need is an ounce of wisdom and a pound of gold, and the hostess, oh, with the mostess on the ball. Entertaining vodka drinkers is a job they give to me. Making nice guys out of stinkers seems to be my cup of tea. What they really need behind the iron wall is the hostess with the mostess on the ball. There's a book of regulations as to who sits next to who, but there might be complications when the blue blood's not so blue. So the priestess with the leastest protocol is the hostess with the mostess on the ball. An ambassador has just reached the shore, he's a man of many loves, an important gent from the Orient to be handled with kid gloves. He can come and let his hair down, ooh, have the best time of his life, even bring his new affair down, introduce her as his wife. But she mustn't leave her panties.